Trump re-election odds explode after first-year tax cuts. After passing major tax cuts in 1981, President Ronald Reagan won re-election in a massive landslide, which hints at President Trump's future. During his freshman year in office, President Reagan signed the Economic Recovery Tax Act of 1981 meant to encourage economic growth through reductions in individual income tax rates. Doesn't that sound familiar? It should, because that was President Trump's primary objective behind his recently passed tax reform bill. Talk is cheap, of course. The proof will come when Americans begin seeing more money in their paychecks as early as February, the White House stated on Thursday. In addition to tax relief for working families, this bill is about restoring America's economic dominance. While excessive business taxes are unseen by many, everyone feels the effects through higher prices and lower wages. By flattening the tax rate for American companies across the board, all businesses, not just the well-connected ones that pay for teams of lawyers and accountants, will be able to invest once more in our country's future. Now, looking back at history, President Reagan won the 84 re-election by taking 49 of 50 states in a lopsided landslide aided by tax reform. That's why the anti-Trump left is melting down with seemingly inappropriate anger over the tax cuts. They know subconsciously that Trump likely secured his re-election. Look at it this way: Trump ran his campaign with a blue-collar platform that Democrats used to campaign on as well. I say used to because Democrats have since abandoned working-class Americans to embrace newly arrived migrants and H-1B workers as their primary voting base. And what did Trump just do? He proved to his working-class voters that their belief in him was well-founded. He validated their hopes as being tangible. And, of course, he put a couple hundred bucks back into their pockets monthly by using tax cuts. Here's another parallel to Reagan. In the early 80s, the Democrats were still somewhat fractured by the competing wings of the party that existed since the late 60s. Today, the Democratic Party is in even worse shape after Hillary Clinton steered party resources away from state and local chapters to fund her failed presidential bid. Hillary's campaign was grabbing money from the state parties for its own purposes, leaving the states with very little to support down-ballot races, former DNC chair Donna Brasile revealed. A Politico story published on May 2, 2016, described the big fundraising vehicle she had launched through the states the summer before, quoting, "Of all she had made to rebuild the party from the ground up, when our state parties are strong, we win. That's what will happen." Yet the states kept less than half of 1% of the $82 million they had amassed from the extravagant fundraisers Hillary's campaign was holding. Now there's a Democratic civil war as Brasile and other party leaders try to cut away Clinton's influence before they can even work at fixing the damage. Given these circumstances, here's a likely scenario for the 2020 election: the Democrats will run an anti-Trump campaign, regardless of their candidate, that will only push people towards Trump as they remember what he's actually done for them and for the country.